The morale in the kitchen is very, very high. We all have each other's backs. We truly do work as a team. And it's one of those places where if you're not there to be part of the team, you'll basically fire yourself. Make no mistakes about it. When you walked into his kitchen, you could hear a pin drop. All you hear is the hood fans and the dishwasher. There was no chit chat. There was no music playing in his kitchen. You were focused on your prepping because you had to get a lot done. This was an upscale place. This was a country club. You know, even our sandwiches were like really pretty. Even our sandwiches were nice. You know, grilled cheese looked good. When he was in the room, that was his stage. And when he wanted something done, it was done. If he wanted it cut this way, it was cut this way. It was the hardest kitchen I've ever worked in, and not just because of his personality and what his expectations were, but it was hard because he changed the menu every day. And he was also the empath in the situation, like Richard is as well. He was always the person who could, like, we would hang out after work with and have beers with and get to know and just sit there and talk about food for hours and hours and hours. Not only was he a great chef with a great palate and a great culinary experience, he was a really kind person. We were always joking. We were always talking shit. We were always laughing. And the morale that he kept in the kitchen was so high. I had so much respect for him. He made waking up in the morning worth it because I knew when I came to work, I was going to be safe. I was going to be treated with respect. And we were going to have fun. Whatever we were going to do that day, I knew we were going to have fun. And we always did. This guy had it. So friendly, so kind, but always watching. Always paying attention, always checking on people, always making sure everything was done a certain way, always making sure that the dishwasher wasn't lagging or the entire kitchen was always immaculate. And when I say immaculate, I mean, I would eat off the floor in that kitchen. Hand to God, I would.